Dear children, welcome to physics class, and today we will revise our topics electric current and potential difference. So starting with electric current, it is basically the flow of charge per unit time. Okay, so the flow of charge per unit time is called electric current. We know that electrons flow inside a wire, so this flow of electrons per unit time is called as electric current. So see children, it the formula for electric current I, it becomes Q by T, where Q is charge and T is time. So if we talk about the units, so the unit for charge will be coulomb, and the unit for time is second, so it becomes coulomb per second, or in SI unit we call it as ampere. So ampere is the SI unit of charge. Okay, so how will you define 1 ampere? So what I will do, I'll place here 1, so 1 can be written as 1 upon 1. Okay, so during definition we can say that 1 ampere is the amount of current in a conductor when 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second. Okay, so the current is 1 ampere. So how we will define it? It is the when 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second, we say that current is 1 ampere in the conductor. Okay, and ammeter is the device that is used to measure current. Okay, so current is measured with a device called ammeter, and this ammeter is always connected in series. Okay, and ammeter measures current either in ampere. Okay, and other units of this electric current is milliampere and microampere. Okay, so milliampere means 10 raised to power minus 3 ampere. Okay, and microampere means 10 raised to power minus 6 ampere. Okay, so these are the other units, smaller units of measuring the electric current. Now children, we will discuss about electric potential. Okay, so electric potential is basically, it is defined as the work done, okay, it is work done in bringing a charge, bringing a unit charge from infinity to any point A in the field of another charge. Okay, so how will you define electric potential? Basically, it is the work done in bringing a unit charge, or we can also say it as it is the work done per unit charge from bringing it from infinity to any point in the field of another charge. So basically, what is the meaning of this statement? Suppose if we have any positive charge here, let us suppose if we have any positive charge, so it will exert, if we take one another positive charge, so it will exert repulsive force on it, and up to what limit, up to where it will exert its repulsion, so we say it that it will repel it up to infinity. Okay, so as we are moving closer to this positive charge, your repulsive force will be more, but as we go on go away from this charge, this repulsion decreases, and finally it becomes zero somewhere at infinity, very far, far away. Okay, so for the sake of simplicity, so suppose I take my this region as infinity, I say it is just for supposing. Okay, so we are supposing here that let us suppose that this is up to here, it has its repulsive force, and this is the limit, means here we are considering it to be infinite distance, very far, far away. Okay, and suppose any another 1 unit positive charge is lying over here. Okay, so it here it will not exert any force, this positive charge will not exert any repulsive force on this charge, but as we enter in this line, enter from this line, now repulsive force will start and we have to apply some force on the charge to move nearer to this positive charge. Okay, so we have to apply force. Now what I do, I take my charge from this point, from this infinity, and I place it somewhere at point A. Okay, so now I have done some work because I have applied the force to move this charge nearer to positive charge because this was repelling. So just to move this charge, I had applied the force and I have moved it from some distance. So force is there, displacement is there, means I have done some work. Okay, and my work done is stored in the form of potential. Okay, so I am writing here it as potential at point A. So this is basically potential. So whatever work I have done in moving my charge from this point, from infinity to this point A, this is called as this is my work done, and this work done is stored in the form of electric potential. So that is how we define electric potential. But suppose now here it is, this charge is lying at this point A, and let us suppose that VA is the potential over here. Now I am considering the case that my charge is lying at point A, okay, and now it has potential VA because somebody has moved it from infinity to this point A. Okay, now what I do in the second case, I move this charge from point A to B. Okay, now I take this charge from point A to B. So see, again I am doing some work, and let us suppose now the potential is VB here. Okay, so basically there is difference in the potential. It was already having some potential VA, now it is having potential VB. So my work done will be equals to VB minus VA, means final potential minus initial potential. This is the amount of work I have done now when I am moving this charge from point A to B. So this, there is difference in the potential, so we call it as potential difference. So see how you will define potential difference. So potential difference, now we are going to define potential difference. Okay, so potential difference can be defined as, it is the amount of work done, again this is work done, it is the amount of work done in moving a unit charge from point, now up to here the definition is same, but in electric, when we are defining electric potential, we are moving it from infinity to any point A. This time we will say from point A to point B, from point A to any point B in the field of another charge. Okay, so dear children, see here, we have here a defined potential difference. Okay, and how basically we measure potential difference in our circuits. Okay, so potential difference, the equation that we are getting is potential difference V equals to work done per unit charge. Okay, so work done upon charge, the unit of work done is joule. Okay, and unit of charge is coulomb. Okay, so unit of charge is coulomb. So the unit becomes joule per coulomb, but in SI unit we call it as volt. The SI unit of potential or potential difference is volt. And how will you define 1 volt? So again in the same manner, I'll put here 1, and 1 will become 1 upon 1. Okay, 1 equals to 1 upon 1, it doesn't make any difference. So 1 volt can be defined as when 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb charge. Okay, so see children, from here we have defined 1 volt potential. Now this potential is measured, the device that we use to measure potential or potential difference is voltmeter. Okay, voltmeter, and this voltmeter is always connected in parallel to the circuit. Okay, it is always connected in parallel, and other units of potential are millivolt, again millivolt and microvolt. So millivolt, milli always stands for 10 raised to power minus 3 and micro stands for 10 raised to power minus 6. So it becomes 10 raised to power minus 3 volt and it becomes 10 raised to power minus 6 volt. Okay, so this is what we want to discuss today and revise it well. So wish you good luck. Today we have discussed about electric current and electric potential and potential difference. We had defined them and we also learned what are the devices that how they are connected and how they measure these quantities. Okay, so revise well. Wish you good luck.